Redondo Beach, born and raised in LA. I took the LA County lifeguard test in 94 and started doing all the surf life-saving lifeguard competitions, which includes swimming, running, surf skiing, paddleboarding on a 10-6 traditional paddleboard on your knees and on your stomach. After Mike Fox, the owner of Boardworks, was at the Lifeguard Nationals, and I've known him for years. After the Nationals, you know, I had some good results in lots of different events that involved paddling, rowing a dory boat, doing the surf ski, paddleboarding, and he's known my background, racing in Hawaii and all throughout the United States. And I haven't really done anything in the stand-up world, and he saw potential to be combined with these new boards that they were making by Morelli and Melvin. Picked me, and I'm really glad he did because I'm loving the board and just enjoying the whole community of stand-up paddling. Even when you go stand up paddle surfing, if you're not trying to hit the lip really hard, you can go for a 2-hour session and stay dry, which is good when it's cold. When I'm training, I don't have to get wet. As far as the community goes, Battle of the Paddle really opened my eyes to the sheer numbers of people. In the open race, there was 450 plus paddlers, and Dick DeBoer let me go on the back of the jet ski, so I watched it from the water. And there was an 8-year-old kid, there was Mickey Munoz, there was Jerry Lopez, there's all these people, athletic people, overweight people, everyone and their mother and their brother can do it, and everyone that's doing it is smiling, so I love it. With Boardworks, having the opportunity to paddle their racing boards and try a few different types of their surfing boards as well. They've got the Paddle Surf Hawaii, they've got the C4s, the Rusties, and their own Boardworks name brand boards. So just getting a chance to try all the different boards, I think helps you improve at a quicker rate. So I just want to see how far I can go with the racing and with the surfing.